More than 15,000 people took to the streets here in Bangkok yesterday. Many of them have occupied government departments and ministries. They blocked a major road here in the CBD yesterday outside police headquarters, basically staged a sit-in. They're only armed with whistles and their national flag, but there were hundreds of riot police that were geared up ready in case anything got out of hand. But as I say, these people are in for the long haul. They erected a stage at the government complex, which has become their headquarters for this protest movement. And they say they will stay here for weeks, if not months, despite the king's birthday, which is next week. He turns 86. This is a man who is revered, he is loved and adored, and nobody wants to upset the king. But protesters say they will continue their fight until the government and the Prime Minister Yingluck Shinawatra resigns. Now, the Prime Minister, she survived a vote of no confidence in Parliament yesterday. That was always going to happen. She holds the majority. However, she came out afterwards, gave a televised address to the nation, calling for these protests to end. Let's have a listen.
We understand that this seizing of government offices is symbolic of their movement. I'm pleading with the protesters to stop doing this because our administration still needs to operate. We government and protesters need to talk. They need to stop their movement first. This would be the best solution so everybody will be relaxed. Then we can discuss the way out for our country.
As you heard from the Prime Minister, she's asking for dialogue, but we spoke to the protest leader yesterday. He's not interested. He just wants her and the government to resign and for there to be political reform. Now, Patricia, as we know, this latest round of tension in this country was sparked by an amnesty bill, which the Prime Minister tried to get through the Parliament. It was knocked down, but the fact that she had even put it forward has angered so many people. If it had been passed, that would have given her brother, Thaksin Shinawatra, who was ousted from power back in 2006 during a military coup, it would have allowed him back into the country. He has been in self-imposed exile since 2008 after he was charged with corruption in 2008. So he has been overseas ever since. But that bill, if passed, would have allowed him back into the country. The people here, certainly the ones who are demonstrating, do not want that, Patricia.
Yeah, certainly not. So, Anna, you said that the protesters plan to fight on. So what are their plans today, and how long do we expect this to go on for?
Yeah, it's the million-dollar question, isn't it, really? We know from recent history, 2008, that protesters sat in government house for something like 193 days. So 6 months they were allowed to occupy government house, and forces didn't move against them. The Prime Minister has said that no force will be used against these protesters. However, she has extended the powers of the police and the military to ensure that law and order is restored on the streets. But no one wants a repeat of the violence that we saw here back in 2010, when demonstrations turned very ugly on the streets of Bangkok, and 90 people were killed, and most of them being civilians. So, as I say, no one wants a repeat of Thailand's darkest moment. As far as the protesters go today, they are prepared to move on to other government buildings. That is their plan. They are going to continue to do this. If anything, it's more of a nuisance. It's a disruption to life here, causing traffic jams, and obviously those buildings are not being properly utilized. I think it's also important to note, Patricia, that a lot of the civil servants working in these buildings actually sympathize with the protesters. So I think it's fair to say that momentum is definitely growing. There could be a much bigger rally come Sunday. That's what we witnessed last Sunday, up to 100,000 people taking to the streets. But the protesters at this stage just say they will continue to fight until they win this war.